name is Eleni Polychroniadou, and I'm the CEO of Sintali, an environmental verification company that acts as a partner for Puma on delivering the EDGE certification for the impact framework. Today, I'm going to show you a little bit about the EDGE app, orient you on how it works, how you can input your data, and start your process towards achieving EDGE certification, before showing you a specific case study of what a self-assessment looks like when it's filled in. So at a starting point, this is our homepage. So this is what it looks like when you first open the EDGE app. And you'll see on the left-hand side, there's a variety of different categories from homes, apartments, service departments, retail, which we're on right now, all the way through to this category at the bottom called mixed use, which is for any building that doesn't fit an existing category. Now, selecting on one of these gives you your typology and subtype, and this will affect the base case that's being calculated. We're currently on the design tab, which is the tab that influences what the building is and how you tell the EDGE app what your design is. We then have the energy tab. This is your comprehensive list of all the options of what you can do to improve the energy efficiency of your building. And these match the right-hand side of the screen, which is our chart, showing a base case calculated behind the scenes on the EDGE app and an improved case. Right now, the improved case you'll see on our screen is exactly the same because we haven't input any data. The colors match what's on the left, so anything that you're selecting which affects the specific color coding on the right will be influenced in the improved case. And we're going to focus on making that better than the base case. Now, just a quick completion of our orientation. The water section looks pretty much the same. We have our different water measures on the left-hand side, and then we've got our chart on the right-hand side with the base case and the improved case. You'll also see at the top, it's showing us what our efficiency savings are. Right now, there's no data in there, therefore we're at 0%. This is the materials tab, slightly different in the sense that we have predefined areas within the building, so floors, roofs, etc. And then we have a drop-down selection of the different types of materials. There is one final tab, and this is where you're inputting your actual operational data ready to go for the EDGE Zero Carbon accreditation. At the top, you've got this bar of information. We'll show you how this looks in practice momentarily when we start looking at how you can evaluate your efficiency measures and the benefits that you're getting out of them. Now, let's look at a couple of case studies and see what does it look like to have a pre-filled assessment. And we're going to start by looking at an example of a care home. There are different types of care homes, some of which have more on-site medical facilities and some of which don't. For those that don't, that have more functionality, such as the bedrooms, wet rooms, shared spaces, those mimic the energy consumption and typical use patterns, such as service departments. And because there aren't any additional medical facilities that would potentially impact things like energy consumption, then we can model them under a service department. Because making sure that this typology is correct is important as the starting point for building the right base case for the assessment. Now you'll see in this example, we selected Maidstone as the city, and this is going to pull in all of the relevant climatic data to help build our base case. We have a couple of sections over here around the project details and the sub-project details. So a sub-project reflects a single asset. You might be a developer of care homes that have multiple assets across different locations. You might be developing a scheme. You might have multiple assets on the same location. So each asset would require its own sub-project. And you'll see over here, we've selected a new building going for preliminary certification. If I move a little bit further down, this is where the information starts to tell the EDGE app what your building design is and how it's going to feed into developing the base case. So you'll have some basic information here around the size of the building, the number of floors, but then also information around the occupancy pattern. So in this case, you can see we've got an average occupancy rate of 80% and some information here around the size, but actually the working days and the hours of operation have been left blank. So if you're not sure at the starting point, you can leave it blank and the EDGE app will make certain assessments and certain assumptions. But after, as you move towards certification, you will need to go back and fill in. We then go into a little bit more detail, thinking about the different areas. How large are the lobbies? How large are the corridors? What are the areas per different segments? So in this case, we've got a care home with 81 studios. On the right-hand side, it's talking about functionality that again may affect areas such as water consumption. So whether there's clothes washing facilities, whether there's dishwashing facilities, etc. Finally, we've got the building dimensions and which way the building is facing. The more information that you put in, the more accurate the building will be. But of course, you can always start with the absolute basics and building it up from there. Right at the bottom are the HVAC systems, so talking about whether the building has an AC system or whether it has space heating, which again are absolutely essential because of course we know that heating and cooling contribute significantly to the carbon emissions and the energy consumption of a building. All of this information on the design tab is your way of telling the system what your building is and ultimately leads into the energy, water, and materials tab to create a relevant base case and the improved case. So you'll see in this case that our improved case no longer matches the base case, but is actually showing a different number. And that's for two reasons. First of all, we've defined what our building actually is, but also we've pre-selected in this case, certain efficiency measures that we would like to implement for this particular care home. The tick marks are the ones that we've selected. And you'll also notice that some efficiency measures have stars, and those are the mandatory measures that are required. Now, using just the mandatory measures, you won't be able to meet the EDGE standard, so you do need to go beyond that, but it gives you a sense of what you need to focus on. So for example, here we've got a U value, and there's actually, if I click on these three dots, you can see there's a calculator integrated already into the EDGE app to help you do those U value calculations. If I scroll down a little bit further, you can see the COP here is blank, and if I actually click on the three dots and go into the further detailed entry, you're able to find a little bit more information and do any types of calculations that are required. So you can see if, for example, you had multiple systems within your particular building, you can add multiple entries, which would allow you to calculate the overall average for the building. Generally speaking, EDGE was designed to be intuitive and to help you. So if you just click on the efficiency measure, you actually get a description of what the measure is trying to show you and also a link for more information to go to the user guide. But the reality is there's a very long list of efficiency measures that you can implement to make sure that your building is meeting your energy savings. Now, in this particular example, is actually not only meeting the EDGE standard, but actually meeting the EDGE advanced standard. And you can see that the software system is already telling you that, which is a really valuable feedback tool, especially if you're using the EDGE app for design decisions. You can also use the information for decision making in terms of ROI and incremental cost versus the efficiency savings. So if I click through the top bar, you can see there are estimates here on the final water use, energy savings, utility cost savings, as well as the carbon savings and the improved case and incremental cost. If I was using the EDGE app right now for my care home to evaluate what is possible, I could select my different measures, input the information that I'm thinking of implementing, and actually evaluate, is this incremental cost that I'm seeing over here worth the savings that I'm going to get compared to the carbon savings and efficiency savings? So really thinking about it as a scenario tool and understanding the different levels of investment that you could make as a developer or an operator of assets. In summary, this graph on the right-hand side is a really good visualization of how the different efficiency measures are impacting different segments that contribute to the overall energy impact of the building. So if we look at a like-for-like comparison in terms of the color coding, we can see that the largest decrease has happened from heating. So by implementing efficiency measures that have been focused on heating, we've gone down from a 34% impact all the way to an 8%. If we now move on to the water tab, you'll see with a multitude of different efficiency measures, this building has managed to achieve a 34% improvement on the water standard compared to the base case. Some of the slightly harder measures to achieve, such as, for example, rainwater harvesting or wastewater treatment, haven't been implemented in this project, and yet we still have the 34% improvement over the local base case. And again, if you look at the graph, you can see where in each of the categories you've had the most impact. For example, water-efficient shower heads, water-efficient faucets on all the bathrooms, water-efficient water closets, all the way through to the kitchen sinks and the dishwashers. Finally, if we move into the materials section, you can see that this building has reduced its embodied carbon by 56%, by making sure to select different materials that are reducing carbon content. Now, the biggest reduction has been in the flooring, from a 60% of the overall impact all the way down to a 17%. This is actually a custom material, and this is another one of the functionalities within the tool. If you open the material section and go through the different materials and realize that your material is not in here, you can input a customized material. So for example, if you're using a material that has an environmental product declaration, you could upload that as supporting material. This is not going to be required if you're not going for certification, but once you start your certification process, you will need to upload these documents into the EDGE app to support the auditor and the certifier reviewing and making a final decision on the certification of this project. Just to give a small example of another project that has a similar care home, but used different efficiency measures, we're still meeting the EDGE standard, although we're not at EDGE Advanced, with the energy tap. But you can see over here, we're not meeting the EDGE standard for the water section. We're only at 8% and we need to get over 20%. So this is where you start to use EDGE as a strategic tool to evaluate what measures have you not implemented that you could, that are plausible. So in this case, for example, I can see that we haven't implemented water efficient washing machines, which might be very relevant for our care home. So I'm going to click on the measure. For now, I'm going to leave the flow rate of 3, and I'm going to click on calculate and save. Generally, when you're clicking on calculations, you might get this holding pattern, and that just simply means that the EDGE app is doing the calculations on the back end. So you can see here, we've improved our water efficiency and surpassed the 20%. So now the software is letting us know that we meet the EDGE standard, which is fantastic. A couple of other points whilst you're working in the EDGE app. At the top, there is a file button, which if you click, you can save your assessment. You can also download a PDF of your EDGE assessment, which might be very useful if you need to submit it for financing due diligence or set up different scenarios and evaluate them internally in terms of setting your sustainability strategy. You can also save as, so this is very useful for portfolios that maybe use a very similar scheme. So for example, if you have different design types, you can save as the design types with the efficiency measures and then save time for yourself and your team. Generally speaking, if you know your building and you have all of the information, it shouldn't take you more than 20 or 30 minutes to fill out an EDGE assessment. And finally, if you've got multiple projects set up, so you can click on the dashboard, you can see all of the different sub-projects that you've created. And you'll be able to see also the summary of efficiency savings, as well as what your carbon savings are. You can also share different assessments with team members. So if you've got multiple people working on projects, you can click share and share with other users on the EDGE app. So it becomes a very good collaborative tool and a great way to be able to aggregate all of your building level data to understand your portfolio and work towards your sustainability goals. So hopefully that's given you a good introduction to the EDGE app. The EDGE app was designed for developers, engineers, architects to be able to use, and is very intuitive. But sometimes it can be helpful to have a little bit of extra support, which is where EDGE experts come in. They're optional consultants, people that have been trained on how to use the EDGE app. Or you yourself could become an EDGE expert through taking EDGE expert training. There's also lots of resources online, the EDGE user guide, and lots of information to help make sure that you feel confident and comfortable with the information you're inputting into the EDGE app. EDGE was designed to make your life easier and to help make EDGE certification and a green building certification program as simple and streamlined as possible. And hopefully, with the introduction today, with seeing how the EDGE app works, you feel comfortable, confident, and ready to get started on your own EDGE journey.